हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक। एज यू ऑल नो इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर, दैट्स लेक्चर नंबर 7, वी हैव टारगेटेड एग्जाम्पल्स टू फाइंड अननोन फ्रीक्वेंसी। वी हैव सो फार, इफ यू कंसीडर इन लेक्चर नंबर 6 एंड 7, we have already covered the topic of finding single unknown frequency or double unknown frequency when mean is given, as well total of the frequencies also given. In both the case we understood how to find unknown frequency. Now what we are planning to take the topic in today's lecture, that is finding unknown frequencies when median and mode are given. We will solve at least 3 to 4 examples in today's lecture where we are looking for finding 2 unknown frequencies when median is given, as well when mode is given. Okay, so dear student, today you are attending lecture number 8, and in today's lecture number 8 we are targeting the topic of finding 2 unknown frequency where median and mode are given. Lecture number 8 today. In chapter number 14, that is statistics, and we are targeting topic in today's lecture finding unknown frequencies, finding unknown frequencies when median and mode are given. You will be given examples in which you have to find unknown frequencies, but at the same time when you are looking for unknown frequencies, you will be provided the value of either median or value of mode. Both will be provided to you. Okay, this is the example we are targeting in today's lecture, dear student. Always remember one thing, you need to remember the process in which we are involved, and you have to demark between the examples what you have done previously in the last lecture number 7. There were no doubt examples to find unknown frequency, but at that time the data was mean was given to you. Understand where, how to mark A, how to calculate the sum, how to find both the unknown frequencies, that we have understood. Now the topic has shifted. Now you are looking for 2 unknown frequencies definitely, but when median and mode is given, let us target few examples when median is given and you are looking for finding double unknown frequency. Okay dear student, question number 1, here in this example Median is given, not down. Median M. The value of the median is given, that is 28.5. This is value of median is given. Not only that, but at the same time you are also given total frequencies. Total of the frequencies is also given, that is 60. Okay, both data, median is given, total of the frequency is also given. Let me write class, okay, and column of frequency as well. Class and frequency F. Classes, let us mention 0 to 10, okay. Classes are given 0 to 10, then given 10 to 20, then given 20 to 30, then given 30 to 40, then given 40 to 50, and one more class, 50 to 60. Classes are given this way as well. Frequencies are also mentioned, not down. 5, that is first frequency, then F1, that is second unknown frequency, then 20, then 15, then F2, second unknown frequency is given, and then 5. Now, dear student, before we solve this example, what is the demarcation line between mean and median in finding both the unknown frequency? That you need to understand. What we were doing while we were finding median of the data, the process was totally different. While we were finding median of the data in simple way, we were looking for the median class by use of the formula M equals to N upon tooth observation. But now, dear student, remember, you do not have to go with that method. The method is going to change a little bit. What you have done in marking median class, understand, while finding the median, here totally process is going to be different. How? Here, dear student, median is already given to you, that is 28.5. Because value of median is given 28.5, can you decide the class in which limit the value of median lies? 28.5 obviously lies in the range of 20 to 30. So this will become your median class. You understood this. Is it clear? But first, as you all know, preparing the column of cumulative frequency. First frequency, that is 5, will become our CF. 5 plus, do not make any mistake in writing this. 5 plus F1, by chance also, student, you should not make mistake writing 5F1. Is it clear? 20 plus 5, this can be written as 25 plus F1, 15 to be added here, 25 plus 15, that is going to be 40 plus F1. Now F2 to be added to this, so it will be 40 plus F1 plus F2. Now 5 is to be added to this, so this becomes 45 plus F1 plus F2, and as every time while solving the examples of median, I say your last cumulative frequency always represents the total of the frequency. You understood? So here no need to find total. Directly you can mention sigma fi equal to 45 plus F1 plus F2. Undoubtedly total of the frequency is also given 60. Okay, this is the way, dear student. First, whatever is necessary in column formation is over. Finding CF, last cumulative frequency represents total of the frequency, though total of the frequency has already been given as 60. Now comes the marking. Because median, please concentrate here, median has been given 28.5, which lies in this boundary of the class 20 to 30. So dear student, when median is given, that is 28.5, you have to decide the class in which this median lie. It look like it is lying in the range of 20 to 30, so this becomes our median class. You understood? You do not need to write, this is for your understanding. You just have to mark only this. This becomes lower boundary of median class. Okay, now this will become frequency of the median class, and as you all know, you have to target the cumulative frequency of preceding class. This becomes CF. This way the marking needs to be done. Okay, median class, from the value of the median 28.5 lies in the range of 20 to 30, then F, frequency, and CF, as you people always do, cumulative frequency of preceding class. Okay, now dear student, it comes the calculation part for the first half. Let me write formula of median. Please note down with me L plus, and concentrate as well here. n upon 2 minus Cf, as you all know the formula very well, upon F multiplied by H. Okay? Correct formula of the median. Now substitution of the values. What is median given? 28.5. What is the value of L you have selected? 20. N upon 2. N, dear student, you do not have to write this N there. You have to target this value, 60 upon 2. Minus cumulative frequency, dear student, 5 plus F1 to be written for simple understanding, 5 plus F1, okay, upon F. What is value of F? That is 20. Multiplied by class height, obviously 10, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, the regular class height. First you see, in substitution of the values, what care you must take regarding this when you write value, okay? Next step. 10 2ja, here one cancellation is possible, 30ja, as well transfer of the term, 28.5 minus 20, 8.5, that's equal to, what is left here, 30, minus 5 plus F1 upon 2. You understood this? Now let us cross multiply. 8.5 into 2, that is 17 equal to, let me open the bracket here, 35 minus 5 minus F1, 17 equals to 30 minus 5, 25 minus F1, transferring F1 on this side, 17 on other side, 25 minus 17, so you got F1 equal to 8. First half is over. We have already found out F1, okay? Now, if we are targeting the second half of the sum, I am continuing here, dear student, okay? Do not want to erase any data at all. Sigma Fi, as you all know, that is already found out by us, 45 plus F1 plus F2, sigma Fi has been given to us, 60 equal to 45 plus F1, that is 8, plus F2, 60 equal to 53 plus F2, just the transfer and you got 7 equal to F2, so second unknown frequency equal to 7. You got F1 as well, you got F2 also. Be conscious how to find unknown frequencies when Midian is given to you, you need to be very conscious, understand, because this psalm is exactly a contradiction to the previous example of finding Midian, where we are deciding the Midian class. Understand, by taking formula n upon 2, not the case here. Here you have to decide Median class from value of median, and accordingly the marking needs to be done. Understand? First, dear student, just for 1 or 2 minutes, you properly verify this particular example, then one more example of finding two unknown frequency when median is given, we will like to solve. First, you verify this properly. You see the column formation. You see the calculative part also. I am drawing a demarcation line between this column formation and calculation solution part. Understand, so that you can verify it properly. Here sometime confusion might arising in writing values and solving and finding the frequency here sometime. So dear student, when you substitute the value, you be very conscious regarding how to substitute value. Suppose here written minus CF and we got CF 5 plus F1. That means you need to write it in bracket so that when you open bracket, no sign mistake anyhow can take place. Verified properly. You observed one thing, the second half. You see, the second half of the sum is as routine as we were doing in mean, okay? There is no variation in that. The only variation lies that is in the first half of the calculation. Correct column formation is required. Understood? Verified properly. Okay. Just see the example. Collect if any doubt remains in your mind or any query when you are solving this example, and when you are looking at this example, you must have written the example in your book. Now verify each and every step how to make column formation, how to mark median class, how to mark frequency and CF, how to substitute the values, and how the calculations are done. You understood this. How you have to be little more accurate enough here to find correct values of the unknown frequencies. Okay, dear student, after this sum is done, I have just what idea I want to give you. Mark your caution point of doubt so that when we solve one more example of median, any of the doubt in your mind can get solved again in the second example. Okay, let us solve one more example to find median of the data. Okay, another example let us target so that it will give you a sufficient practice to understand any doubt which may remain in your mind, has remained in your mind. Okay, one more example to find unknown frequency when median is given. Let us take it. Please note down the median has already been given. Okay, let me take one example. Note down, median is given 50 already, and total of the frequency is given 60. Let us write the class. Okay, median is 50 and total of the frequency is given 60. Median of the frequency distribution is 50 and total frequency is 60. Let us write the class. Note down with me 0 to 20. Okay, then 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, then frequencies F, that's given frequency 5, then given X, then given 20, then given Y, and at last the frequency of the last class has been given 2. This is the example. As we do every time in median, find cumulative frequency 5 as it is, 5 plus X, add in this, 25 plus X, add in this, 25 plus X plus Y, add in this, 27 plus X plus Y, last cumulative frequency always represent the total of the frequency sigma Fi. I should mention from here only. Is it clear? No, 5 plus X, okay, 25, okay. Let me write 27 plus X plus Y, though the total of the frequency has already been given. Understood? Now, dear student, again the question of marking, okay? Just see what is the median given 50. Because median is given 50, it lies in the class 40 to 60. You understood? So this will become your median class, and in this median class, this becomes lower boundary of median class. Frequency against the median class is to be represented as small f. Cumulative frequency of preceding class has to be designated as CF. The process of marking is over. Median class, again dear student, just now you are explained only particular example of median, but at that time when you are preparing the whole chapter, understand, at that time this minor confusion is going to arise in mind, that when mean is given, how to find two unknown frequency. And when median is given, how to find two unknown frequencies, the practice of such examples more and more will help you to master the track of solving the example. What to do in mean, what to do in median is drastically and entirely a different process. Understood? Now comes the calculation part, dear student. Markings are over. Okay? Now calculation part. And in calculation part, although the first half, let me take formula of median. L plus N upon 2 minus CF upon F into H, that is class height. Even student, when you are attending one topic, suppose we take, when you are attending the topic of mean, at that time the same topic continues for the whole one or two lecture, so that formula remains in your mind. Then when mode is continuing, so until the examples regarding mode continues, that formula again and again highlights in your mind and it becomes easy for you to remember. Now when you are dealing with median, just now we are doing, the same process is going to reoccur in your mind, that because you are solving examples of median, so again and again that is going to struck in your mind, M equal to L plus N upon 2 minus CF upon F into H. But when it happens that you are preparing the whole chapter at all, at that time the mixing of the formulas are going to occur, and I have seen students making mistake even in writing correct formulas. So be very very conscious regarding this. Value of M we know, 50. Value of L we know, 40. N upon 2, that is 60 upon 2. CF, that is 5 plus X upon F, that is frequency given 20, multiplied by class height of 20. Simple cancellation, 20 got cancelled. Here you need to cancel 230 ja. Now transfer of the term 50 minus 40, that is 10 equal to again 30 minus 5 plus x. See the calculation, because when you solve example no mistakes should occur and you should understand the track of solving the example. Understand? The track is very important, how to solve any example. And now, as you know, 10 equal to 30, let us open the bracket. 10 equal to 25 minus x. So x equal to 25 minus 10, so x equal to 15. Try to understand the cancellation and calculation done so far properly in previous example as well. In this example also, the third half of the example, okay? First, unknown frequency has been calculated, x equal to 15, giving you a little time to write and understand, because it may happen that you don't pass up with me and not able to write. So just understand and write down. X equal to 15 we already got. Understood. Now our target is to find another unknown frequency, and for that sigma fi, what is the total? 27 plus x plus y. What is sigma fi? Already given, 60 equal to 27 plus x, that is 15, plus y. 60 equal to 27 plus 15, it is 42, plus y. Just transfer 60 minus 42, that's y. Understand, 42 plus 8, 50, 18 equal to y. Therefore, y equals to 18 we got. Verify the example, dear student, properly. Understand, I am giving you 2 minutes time to just have a look at the examples we have done, so that when homework is delivered to you, understand, you can do homework without any doubt at all. When you have understood the process properly here, verify this properly. How the example is solved. Understand how to decide median class. You will start thinking, why sir is speaking again and again the same statement, how to decide median class. The purpose is to implant in your mind the procedure of marking while you find two unknown frequency. From the value of the median, you will decide your median class, and with reference to that median class, you have to take F and CF. Understand, not only that, dear student, but very important is when you substitute the value and mathematically you do correct calculation and able to reach the final answer. Understand? Verify this properly, right? Okay, clear in your mind how to find two unknown frequency when median is given and total of the frequency is given. Mark one thing, dear student, whenever you are looking for finding two unknown frequency, you will always be provided measure of the central tendency, either mean, median or mode. Not only that, you will at the same time also provided with total of the frequency. Both will be given to you. Then and then you are able to find two unknown frequencies. Okay, Now, dear student, try to understand in today's lecture. We have targeted, like in previous lecture, I targeted how to find two unknown frequencies when mean is given. Now, in today's lecture, I have targeted to find two unknown frequency when median is given, okay? Today we are not going to take another topic of finding two unknown frequency when mode is given. That we are going to target in our next lecture. Understand? Those examples are also, dear student, some tricky example when mode is given and finding two unknown frequency. Okay, let us note down what will be the homework for today's lecture. Like every time, dear students, some of the examples which we solve here, understand, those examples are also very important for you. Understand? So what is the homework in today's lecture is, whatever example we have done, solve both examples. Whatever examples we have done, solve both example twice, and another homework from our SLP 4, self learning practice 4, some of the examples for homework for you. Okay, from SLP 4, you have to solve example number, I am mentioning the number here. First you will solve example number 2, where median is given and two unknown frequencies are given. Then example number 3, equally the similar example, okay. Then example number 8, where also median is given and two unknown frequencies to be found out. Then example 9, where also two unknown frequency and median is given, as well example number 10, where you will target single unknown frequency. Here, dear student, when you solve examples of single unknown frequency when median is given, follow the routine process. But deciding median class, that I have already explained to you. From the value of the median, median class can be determined, and after determining the median class, accordingly you can solve the example. Okay, so in today's lecture, as per our target, we targeted the examples to find median of two unknown frequency when median is given. Okay, dear student, thank you very much.